Welcome today. We're going to talk about CRF design, and as we know that there are certain caveats about best practices or how we best design. There are also, you have received some handouts, and basically we're going to stress during the course of, let's say, this 2 hours coming up about standards, because now we can actually implement standards, and all pharma, all devices, all CROs can basically go back to the standards from a CDASH capability or certain case report forms that would be most conducive for the exchange of data, et cetera. And we're going to look at the CDM focus on protocol review to identify data requirements. And one of the things that doesn't happen very often in our discipline is, let's say, how to read a protocol or how to identify certain protocol elements that would be part of data management. We'll implement the best practices for ECRF design, EDC, and paper forms. The case report forms function differently, and we'll discuss the customization of case report forms, because as we know, every therapeutic area may have custom forms that collect data that is specific to, let's say, that patient population or the disease. And we'll speak about CDASH standards, because CDASH is the data collection instrument. CDISC is the data format that will be used for submission to FDA. And then we'll identify data compatibility issues and solutions to ensure appropriate data integration, and that will involve pretty much external data. So case report form, definition, we've seen these definitions multiple times, and basically the second definition, ICH, is the one that maybe we are most familiar with, and that is that printed optical or electrical document that is designed to record all of the protocol required information. First one is basically it's a record, and for all of the data that's being collected for a subject that is participating in a clinical trial based on the protocol. The working definition is a tool designed by the sponsor to capture transcription of protocol-specific subject data from source. And as we all know, the CRFs are based on the protocol. So in other words, if it's in the protocol that says that we're going to collect it and it is required for statistical analyses, we then need to have a way that we can collect that information in the appropriate format required by our statisticians. So the purpose of the case report form, the entire packet, is really to answer the hypotheses formulated in the study protocol. So we are having a protocol, and it's like drug A versus drug B in this patient population is superior to, and a lot of times, or this is a double-blind study, such and such. In the title of the protocol, the hypothesis is what you believe, what you're going to prove based on the data that you're going to collect. We also need to provide the relevant safety data. Every study that we do, whether it's phase 1 through phase 4, the component of safety is of a primary interest as well. So first in man, phase 1, safety data, we don't have efficacy usually, unless we're doing cancer chemotherapy or other studies where you might have disease already in place. But basically, phase 1 is significantly oriented towards safety. And then for the case report form, we really need to ensure that the precise collection, collation, analysis, and reporting of the data. From a data management standpoint, our remit is to deliver a quality database. And that database has to be representative of the information that is gathered from the protocol. So we need that case report form to capture those data appropriately. So we want to ensure that our case report forms request the precise information required by the protocol. This one, I always joke about this in a certain respect, because as data managers, we sometimes have to assume the role of devil's advocate. We want to have the data that is only required by the protocol. And I know that any one of you sitting here today probably been in an environment where someone will say, but this data would be really nice to have, or I'd like to have that, even though we're not going to analyze it. The problem with that is having that nice to have data, how much are we going to spend as far as resources and time cleaning data that will never be analyzed? So it's something that we need to have our study team contemplate before they actually insist on collecting data that will never be analyzed. We want to ensure that our CRF request information, that the completion is relatively simple, quick, and unambiguous. And I can tell you a story about a case report form that I was working at Sanofi Pasteur with vaccination studies in infants. Hypothesis was that your child was not going to get a fever as a result of getting a pentavalent vaccine. And we collected body temperature. And that form was so incredibly convoluted, and we had 3,500 children in the study. Each child had 8 visits, and of the 8 visits, we had a temperature collection at each one. So you take 3,500 children times 8 times at least, I'm going to say each form emitted 6 discrepancies. So all of those discrepancies with query notes. It was a nightmare. Our colleagues in France who were the keepers of the standards refused to change the form. And so basically we had to do some preventive action, some color coding of the form. It was paper, and trying to help the sites collect the data appropriately. We want to ensure too that our case report forms present the information in a logical sequence. So we usually design in the ECRF the visits and the assessments as they are described in the protocol.